Hi guys, today we are going to review the highly anticipated Acer Nitro 5 2020 edition. There are some significant upgrades over the previous generation. Like this comes with 1010 Intel processor, completely new design, awesome RGB backlit keyboard, and a new cooling system. That sounds like a jet engine. Now, without any delay, let's jump right in. Let's talk about the specs. The unit we got here has Intel Core i5-10300H processor, NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1660 Ti 6GB graphics card, 15.6-inch Full HD IPS 144Hz LCD display, 8GB DDR4 RAM, 512GB PCIe NVMe SSD. The specs may differ according to region, so make sure to visit Acer's website to find out what is available in yours. For more information on this model, please hit the link in the description below. The build quality is decent considering the price, but there is a good amount of screen flex and the laptop doesn't look like it will survive a fall. The design is a welcome change. This looks much more premium than the last year's model thanks to the metallic coating and the sleek form factor. The Acer logo and the red accent is not too imposing. As for the ports, from the top right corner down, you have an HDMI slot, a USB 3.0 port, and a USB Type-C port. On the left-hand side, you have a Kensington lock, an RJ45 Ethernet port, two USB 3.0 ports, and an audio jack. The charging is on the back. The screen on this unit is 144Hz IPS panel. The colors are vibrant and are very pleasing to look at. The viewing angle is great too. Of course, there is a difference when compared with a higher color gamut panel, but considering the price, I am satisfied. But the unit we received has a strong backlight bleed at the top, which is very noticeable even when the room is well lit. So we contacted Acer and they said they will replace it. The quality of the webcam is not that great. It is too grainy and does not even compete with my other 4-year-old laptop. If you want to live stream or something like that, it's better to buy a good webcam. The speakers on this device is also not good. There is virtually no bass and listening to music was not a pleasant experience. The typing experience on this device is just okay. The key travel distance is a bit less for my liking, and also it feels a bit on the softer side. Even though the power button is at the corner, you don't have to worry about shutting down the laptop accidentally pressing it. You have to press it for 4 seconds to get a pop-up window with different options to choose from. What I really like about this model is the RGB backlit keyboard, which is cool and really fun. There are a lot of things you can do with the LED using the NitroSense software. The backlight is also bright enough and looks really good in dim light. The trackpad feels solid, there's no wobbliness to it, it is smooth and pretty accurate. The battery life is not that great. In our test, it lasted for about 3.5 hours on medium screen brightness and balanced power settings. The cooling system is much improved than the last gen model. This now has 4 vents for dissipating heat. The fan gets pretty loud when under stress, but it helps to keep the temperature down. Under normal day-to-day usage, you'll hardly notice it. Here are some benchmark tests we did. The temperature has been reasonably low in all the tests. When the fan is set to max, the temperature gets even lower. We also tested the performance with Autodesk Maya. We will make a separate video specifically for Maya usage, but in this review we can confirm that we have not experienced any issues with the viewport. We will be discussing it in more detail in the upcoming video. So, who is this laptop for? If you absolutely don't want to spend more than 1000 euros, I think you'll be satisfied with this. If your 3 or 4 year old laptop just died and you need a replacement, I think you'll like it. Of course, once you move from this price bracket, you can go for better processor, better graphics card, more RAM, and so on. But at this price point, Acer Nitro 5 is a really good option. If you go for it, you'll not be disappointed. So what do you think of the Acer Nitro 5 2020 edition? Let me know in the comments below. And if you are into 3D animation, we'll be adding more content, so make sure to subscribe. Until then, take care.